The title of today's webinar is Signify Lighting Academy, Shine Some Light on LEED. It will be presented by Cindy Malinchak. Cindy Plans Malinchak joined Signify North America in 2015, representing the company in advanced technologies in the public sector. In this role, Cindy is a consultant to state and local governmental officials and their departments in developing best practices as they relate to advanced technologies, enterprise systems, and services. With her Master of Science degree in Green Technologies and a Sustainable Design and Construction Management certification from NYU, Cindy has gone on to achieve LEED AP-BD&C certification as well as Certified Energy Manager and is a Certified Park Smart Advisor. Now, without further delay, I will now hand over to Cindy for her presentation.
So today we're going to go over the LEED BD&C requirements for version V4 on the lighting requirements and how to obtain your points. And because this is a certified AIA presentation, please make sure to provide your name if you need a certified credit. So for our course description today, we're going to look at a few areas. We're going to look at what is LEED V4 and how do you achieve your points in sustainable lighting practices. And we're going to look at what are some of your best practices for interior and exterior lighting compliance. When you look at the ASHRAE 90.1, so ASHRAE, the American Society of Heating and Refrigerated Air Engineers, is kind of the baseline for what LEED is referencing. It's kind of our reference guide. Between ASHRAE 90.1 and the IES Society, we're really looking at two standard organizations that put forth guidelines to follow in order to achieve your LEED points. And what ASHRAE has done is they've really looked at various types of buildings and defined a baseline value or a lighting power density by building area. And that's a watts per square foot for different types. And you'll notice that you can actually see the varying lighting power density recommendations based on the different school types, different types of buildings, different manufacturing facilities. So pay attention to that because that's how you achieve your points. Make sure that you're using your outdoor space lighting appropriately. And if you look at 90% of the regular occupied space should achieve a weighted reflectance value, and this comes down to the colors that you choose. Do not underestimate what color reflectance can do to your lighting loads. Obviously, you know, you've got to also take into account comfort. So white and lots of light might create glare, but if you're picking a lot of dark colors, then you might have to use additional lighting wattage to actually get the foot candles